Are you looking for a simple and easy way to capture what you see on your computer screen to save for later or to share with others? It's really easy to do. My name's Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer. And in today's video, I'm going to teach you everything that I know about how to take screenshots on your Mac. Screenshots are a super valuable tool, and they've been around on our computers forever, but most people are barely using the minimum of what's capable. In today's video, we're going to learn how to take full screen screenshots, partial screenshots, screenshots of just one window, and how to do a screen recording on your computer that you can use to save a slideshow or PowerPoint presentation or anything else that you want to do. To start with, let's hop over to the computer. So for us to get started, we need to learn the key code that you should be using to take screenshots. And there's three separate key codes that we're going to talk about. They're all very similar and related to each other. The first thing you're going to want to do is hold the Command and Shift button down on your keyboard. Then, if you want to take the entire screen, it's Command Shift 3. You'll hear it take the picture, and then it'll show up in a little preview window in the lower right-hand corner. But if you don't do anything, that just slides away and disappears. Where'd it go? Well, we're going to talk about that in a moment. But what if you don't actually want the entire window? You just want a part of the window. So if I want to create a partial screen screenshot, I'm going to do the same Command Shift on my keyboard, but this time I'm going to press the number 4. And I suddenly get these crosshairs, and these crosshairs allow me to click and drag over any image on the screen that I want, and it will only take a picture of that image. When you release the mouse, it takes the picture and it shows up in the lower right-hand corner in the preview screen and then slides away again. Now there's one other thing that we want to talk about with regard to partial screenshots. And for this example, I'm going to pull my calendar up. I can do the Command Shift 4 and I'll have the crosshairs and I can run it across this screen. But because it's the entire window, there's an easier tool. So it starts the same way, Command Shift 4 and you get the crosshairs. But before you drag them, press the spacebar on your keyboard. You'll notice that the crosshairs turn into a little camera and the entire window gets highlighted in blue. If I click the mouse down, it will take a picture of this window exactly without my having to drag and drop across the entire image. The nice thing about this window capture tool is if you move the camera to another window, like Safari behind us, it will take that screenshot even though part of that window is obscured by the calendar. It doesn't matter. It takes the entire window of anything that you highlight. When you click down, you'll hear the screenshot. You'll see it show up in the lower right-hand corner, and then it'll disappear again. Now let's talk about the most powerful screenshot key code. It's the same two buttons to start with, your Command and your Shift button, but this time we're going to press the number 5. And what we get is a little overlay down at the bottom of our screen. You'll also see in this case, it's showing a partial side of my window. Now down at the bottom, I can choose how I want to capture the screen from here. If I click on the far left, it'll capture the entire screen. If I click in the middle, it'll capture the window, just like when I pressed the spacebar a moment ago. And if I click on the dotted lines here, it will allow me to click any part of the screen and make a partial screenshot. Now we can do all of those same things with Command Shift 3 and Command Shift 4. But what Command Shift 5 also opens up is screen recording capabilities, and that's what we see down here. Here I can record the entire screen or just a part of the screen. To the right here, you're going to notice this Options button, and the Options button is really important. At the top, it tells us where our screenshots are going. And you can choose your desktop, your documents, or any other location you like. You've also got the option to create a timer. Timers are really helpful when you're doing a screen recording because you may need to press the play button on that video before it actually starts recording. So a 5-second or a 10-second timer gives you a little bit of time to get yourself together before it begins the recording. And down here, you've got the options for microphones. This is important if you want your recording to hear what you're saying in addition to what's happening on the computer. If you're in a conference call and you're a part of that conference call, you may want to hit the microphone so that your part is also recorded. But if you're just watching something and you're making noise on your computer, it's easier to leave the microphone set to none because then you can make whatever noise you want and it won't be included inside of the recording. Down at the bottom, you've got a couple of options like the show floating thumbnail, which is what we saw in that lower right corner. That should definitely be turned on. The remember last selection, this is really helpful so you don't have to keep recreating your settings every time. And also show mouse clicks. And those are all the different options that you've got. Once you've got your settings accurate, you can press the return button on your keyboard or the record button here and it will start to record. When you do that, you'll notice a little icon on your menu bar that shows that it's recording. And when you're ready to stop, all you have to do is click on that and it will show the recording in the little preview. And again, if we don't do anything, it'll slide away and in my case, save itself into the desktop section. These are all really powerful tools, but they're not the only tools that exist for screenshots. So now let's learn how to mark up and share a screenshot. First thing we're going to do here is take a simple screenshot of this calendar window. Command-Shift-4 gives me my crosshairs, spacebar, and then click the mouse. Here's our screenshot. Let's click on it this time. When you click on the preview, it opens up into this window, which can allow you to easily share it by clicking here, and you can share it via text, via email, you can put it in your notes, you can add it to your photos, whatever you want to do there. You can delete it in case you made a mistake and that's not the right screenshot you wanted to capture, or by clicking this button here, you open up the markup toolbar. On the left side, you've got two different drawing tools. This one is called the sketch tool. And the sketch tool is valuable because if you draw a circle, it will complete the circle for you. If you use the drawing tool, it will give an exact representation of what you do. It won't try and fix it or complete the circle or do anything else like that. I prefer to use the sketch tool because it allows me to make a real quick arrow that looks great without my having to be great at drawing. In addition to the sketch and draw tools, you've got the shape tools over here, which can allow you to bring in a circle or an arrow or a star or anything else that you want to bring in. You can format whatever you do by clicking on the object and changing the settings that you see here. So let's click on this circle that's got a white space in the middle, and let's change that. Over here where we see the white space, let's set it to no fill. Now I can see through the circle, but I don't really like the color of the circle. So I'm going to click here and make the circle red, and click here and make it a little bit thinner. From here, you can even add a shadow to it really easily. And that makes it simple for you to show somebody exactly what they need to see on a particular screenshot. You can even add your signature if you've taken a screenshot of a contract or something you need to sign. Or you can add text by clicking here, which gives you a little text box that you can put anywhere on the screen to really make sure somebody understands what you're trying to communicate. You can format by clicking here and making it bigger, or changing the color, or bolding it, and all sorts of other tools. So within all of these pieces, you can really take your screenshot to the next level, making sure it's clear what you want people to see and making it visual and easy to understand. And then when you're ready, you can either hit done and it will save to the normal location with all of your markups, or you can click the share button and send it to whoever needs to see it. And those are the basic tools that we've got for taking screenshots on a Mac. But there's more to talk about. In a moment, I'm going to share with you my favorite third-party screenshot app. But before I do, if you've already learned something new and gotten value out of this video, take a moment and hit the thumbs up button so that other people can easily find this video. Now, let's step into the MacWhisperer bonus tip. For most people, the screenshot tools that exist built in for Mac are plenty. But I need something more. I do a lot of screenshots and I need additional capabilities. So I've started using a program called CleanShot X to do my screenshots. It uses the exact same key codes and rides on top of the existing screenshot tools, but it also augments them and adds some additional features. You can buy CleanShot X for a one-time price of $30 from their website. But if you love applications like I do and you love finding great tools that can help you do lots of things, you may want to consider a subscription to this site, Setapp. Setapp gives you a one-time price for hundreds and hundreds of different apps, and it's something that I use on a regular basis. CleanShot is one of the tools I highly recommend using. Once you've got CleanShot installed, it shows up in your menu bar up at the top. If you click on it, you can see all the tools that are available, but you don't really need to use the menu bar because the same Command Shift 3, 4, and 5 work here as well. If I press Command Shift 3, it's going to take a full screenshot, but this time it goes to the left side. That's where CleanShot saves your screenshots. And what's great is it's not going to disappear. It's just going to stay there. So if I need to take an additional screenshot, Command Shift 4, and highlight a couple of other things, you'll notice they show up right above the other screenshot. And I can even do another one. For this one, let's go back to my calendar, Command Shift 4 space, click. Now on the left side, I've got all of these screenshots together and I can use them whenever I want to. If I hover over the preview window, I have some options. I can pin this screenshot so I can find it quickly. I can copy it so I can paste it somewhere. I can save it to my computer, or I can mark it up by clicking on the little pencil icon. The markup tool is very similar to what Apple's got, but it's a little more intuitive. All of your tools are already ready. You don't need to click on the markup button. You can click on arrows. You can redesign things any way you want. You can grab your circle and put it anywhere. You can change the color of anything you're doing. You can change the thickness of the lines that you're doing. You can add shadows. You can add text. All of those same capabilities, they're just a little easier to access. But my favorite part of CleanShot is this little drag me button that you see at the bottom. This means I can take this screenshot when I'm done. I don't have to click a share button. I can click it and I can just drag it directly to where I want, drop it right into my mail, and it will open up that screenshot as an attachment to a new mail message. And I can drag and drop any of those into all sorts of different apps, like into notes or into messages or into reminders, making it even more convenient. But the single best thing that CleanShot does is it remembers my history, which means that I can come up to the CleanShot icon up here and pull down to where it says Capture History, and it's going to show me all of the screenshots I've done in the last several days so that if there's one from a week ago, I can pull that up and immediately reuse it, open it up, mark it up, and do whatever else I need to do. And the last tool I want to talk about for CleanShot is something I just learned that it did this week, and it's super valuable. Sometimes you're on a website and you need to take a screenshot of the entire web page, but unfortunately it's a long web page and there's a whole lot of information there. If you take a normal screenshot, you're going to take one screenshot, scroll, take another screenshot, scroll, and then you're going to end up with 77 different screenshots. But with CleanShot, you can do it differently. Here's how you do it. The first thing you want to do is you want to enter into the CleanShot power menu, which you get to with the Command Shift 5. From here, you're going to notice a lot of options. I'm going to choose the scrolling option here, and I'm going to click on auto scroll. Now it's going to capture this entire web page for me without my even having to lift a finger. It's grabbing all the information it needs, all of the separate ingredients, all the rest of the recipe, and when it's done, I can click done on it, and it's going to save that directly to my preview window. Let's take a look at how it did. I can click on this, and here we've got this entire scrolling screenshot with everything that I need in one quick motion. Now I can save it, or I can share it, or I can drag it, or I can do whatever I need to do to capture that information without making myself crazy. So those are the best tips that I know about how to take screenshots on your Mac. If you want to explore Setapp, you can drop into the descriptions down below, and I've got a link there that will allow you to sign up for a free trial. Full disclosure, if you do click that link, I'm an affiliate for Setapp, and I will get a little bit of compensation. But the important thing to know is I would do it anyways. I really think Setapp is a game changer and offers so many tools, of which CleanShot is just one of them. In future videos, I'll talk about some of my other favorite tools that exist there that help me with my calendaring solutions, managing my menu bar, saving space, and so much more. My name's Dylan Stewart. They call me the MacWhisperer, and it's my passion and profession to help you get more done with your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And I will see you at the next video.